Hi, it's Dr. Smith, and today I want to talk to you about a new treatment that we're having some success with in COVID-19. So first, if you would watch MedCram video number 65, which explains how the coronavirus affects the ACE receptor and causes increased production of angiotensin II, which is pro-inflammatory, and decreased production of angiotensin 1-7, which is anti-inflammatory, that would help you understand what I'm going to tell you here. When you get this virus, typically you have no symptoms because the symptoms occur with the production, increased production of angiotensin II and then superoxide and reactive oxygen species and inflammatory cytokines. And cytokine storm is what kills you. So as you see, the virus goes up, the angiotensin II goes up, but you're not seeing any superoxide here in this line because the body has an antioxidant system that takes care of it. In fact, a special enzyme, superoxide dismutase, is designed just to do that. So before you can have symptoms, you have to overwhelm the system, which happens if your viral load and your production of this exceeds your body's antioxidant capacity. And if you're older, got diabetes, got toxin exposures, have genetic anomalies, these can all contribute to reduced antioxidant capacity. Now, some people, they have very high levels of antioxidants, and these people don't get sick. They have the viral load, they have the angiotensin II, but they never make excess superoxide because their antioxidant system just gets rid of it all. So they don't get sick. Eventually, their immune system comes up and takes care of the virus. They spread the virus, they're infected, but they just don't get sick. So the people that get sick, once they get sick, their antioxidant capacity starts to be used up after they've used their baseline. And these people are really sick and really in trouble. These people moderately so. So it depends on where you are in the scale and how soon you can convert this virus line from going up to start to going down. When I realized that superoxide was the problem, a light came on. Well, we know how to deal with that. We treat this all the time with chronically ill patients. Pain patients, they have a lot of cytokines, been able to get their pain down overnight using glutathione and lipoic acid, about 80% reduction in pain, and actually before they even leave the office. So the problem is lack of antioxidant capacity. We can put that in an IV or orally and just give it to the patient. So we did. We gave 2,000 milligrams of glutathione, which is a pretty good dose, 500 of lipoic acid, about the same of NAC. And what happened? Well, they got well. They got well fast. They were better overnight. Now, we've only treated a couple of patients, but here's what happens. When they raise the glutathione, remember, glutathione reacts with superoxide instantly. And then what follows if the superoxide is driving the inflammatory cytokines, they fall quickly as well. So everything that's driving this disease goes down. Now the lipoic acid, I think, is the magic sauce because the lipoic acid gets into the fatty tissue and that's where the action is in COVID. The capillary linings in particular are inflamed. And so the lipoic acid is particularly useful of getting that inflammation down. Now we only have two cases, so that doesn't prove anything, but I'm producing this video in hope that other physicians will try this therapy. It's quite easy to do, and we can get more cases than we have enough evidence to support a request for a trial being done. Dr. Horowitz in New York has had treated two patients. He's reported in the literature with similar results. In fact, those patients got better within the hour. So I hope other physicians will take this up and give it a try and get back to us and see what kind of results they have as well. I'm going to put a note in the video notes as to a link to the full protocol written link. Thank you very much.